Hello, my name's Danny Morgan. It's amazing. I've never been to FrightFest before. I've heard a lot about it, and from what I've seen so far, it's just a really fun place to be. The fans, horror fans, are notoriously crazy and enjoy the hell out of films when they're in screenings and laugh and cheer and stuff. So we're hoping for some of that. We're hoping it's not just blank faces wondering why they've come away from the sunshine and stared at us for an hour and a half. So double date, it's very briefly, it's two guys, two girls, set over one night, and it's the worst double date ever. It's two guys who think they're getting lucky and two girls who are actually out to kill them, but they don't know it. And that's basically the one joke that I've managed to drag out for an hour and a half. Well, I liked the idea of having a central character whose main fear was talking to women. Not that this is something I can relate to, obviously. I'm a total player. But Jim is paralyzed with fear of talking to women, and the one night that his mate manages to get him over this fear just happens to be the one night that he really should have stayed at home. And so I liked that idea. I thought that was a lot of fun, and that kind of sparked it all off, really, and then we went from there. So we wanted to play around with the genre a bit and the things that you'd expect to happen. And also, I just found it quite funny of having this pathetic guy going out for a date with these two homicidal maniacs. I just found that quite amusing, the fact that they were obliviously wandering into hell, basically, with a big smile on their face. And so, I wanted the female characters to be really strong and terrifying, but also be, you know, not one-dimensional and actually have a bit of backstory and a bit of life and soul about them. So, we liked playing with that expectation. We've got myself playing Jim. We've got the brilliant Michael Socker playing Alex, my best friend. We've got Kelly Wenham playing Kitty. And we've got Georgia Groom playing Lulu. They're the two crazy sisters. And, we got really lucky with the cast. So it was just kind of Georgia and Michael were sort of heaven sent, really. There were a couple of weeks before we started shooting, we still didn't have a Lulu and an Alex, and then our brilliant casting director Anna Kennedy gave us Michael and Georgia, and we're just so thankful because they smashed it, and Kelly is brilliant and terrifying, and so I'm really, really happy with the cast. I think there's something about horror that gets people out and into cinemas, and it's still the one genre that does really well in cinema, and I think it's because it's got that ready-made audience who want to come out and sit with a bunch of strangers in the dark, get scared, enjoy that feeling together. It's a really communal atmosphere, which I think is just great, and so that was one of the reasons why I wanted to do horror. I love horror, and I thought it would be a good way to find an audience without necessarily a big cast list or a lot of money or something, because horror fans are just the best.
Hello, I'm Georgia Groom, one of the actors in Double Dates.
Georgia, fantastic to have you here at FrightFest. What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's festival?
It's exciting. I think I've been here before, but I'm not sure I have. So it's fun. It's nice to be somewhere that kind of celebrates a fun genre of film. So that's good. So I play Lulu, who is one of the sisters of the film. And she's kind of owned, I guess, by her older sister Kitty, and is embroiled in Kitty's master plan. It's hard not to say it without spoilers, but she's kind of probably a bit beaten down, but also has, you know, she's doing it. She's pretty badass and gross. And it was nice reading it to see a character that was kind of written really strongly, and they're so there on the page, Danny's writing so good that it kind of instantly came to life, and the relationship between the girls as well. And just seeing how it felt like they were strong as opposed to being an object of the male gaze or anything like that. So I read it and was straight in.
The horror genre does sometimes get a bad rap for the cliche of having women as victims and men as the danger. Was it nice to find a project like this that deliberately and consciously subverts that narrative?
Yeah, and really exciting. You read so much stuff and you see so much stuff where that's not the case. And I think especially with horror as a genre, you're ready to see kind of the girl covered in blood going, ah! and running for our life. And in this, it's completely reversed, which is just really fun to play with because it's funnier, actually, to see men running for their life and screaming and crying. So that was really nice and quite exciting. And I think, you know, my favourite type of horror films are the ones where they are a bit slapstick and funny. And even if you look at kind of Shaun of the Dead, not that it's a horror film, it's that kind of vibe that I really like. So to see that on the page, but also to see it subverted, was just really cool. And I think they did a good job of getting that from page to screen as well. And it, the team, you know, mainly there was the four of us actors, and Michael Socker, who's not here today, is one of the, I mean, they're all very funny, but Michael is horrifically funny. And we grew up together, I've known him since we were like five. He would have been a bit older. So to get to work with Michael was a dream, because it's been a long time coming. And just, I think when there's four of you and there's not that many kind of people coming in and out, you get to know each other really well. And kind of we got to improv, and, you know, Ben, director, was really good at letting us do that. So you just end up having a bit of a laugh, which makes it nicer. So we were on 3 weeks of night shoots, which painful. You know, you don't see anybody else in your life for those 3 weeks other than the people you're working with. So it was really nice to kind of have a small team, a young team. Most of the crew were kind of young. We had a female DOP, which is still pretty unheard of. So that's super exciting to kind of have her there and leading the crew, really. That everyone just had a great time. I know that sounds like a cliche, but it genuinely was quite funny to make. Well, I think horror, the nice thing about horror is that people still go to the cinema to watch it. I'd never sit and watch a horror film on my own. I like to have other people to bounce off. So I think FrightFest has given people a chance to kind of have their film seen on the big screen where they might probably not. And it's a genre that kind of brings people together, I think.
Hello, my name's Kelly Wenham. Kitty is the villain of the film, and she is a very dark, psychotic, quite aggressive, deranged person.
And what was it about that role that appealed to you as a performer?
I just thought it would be fun and a huge personal challenge as well to play someone like that. And I was really happy that she was such a strong, kick-ass character. Yeah, I felt honoured to be considered and to do it. I think we both have sisters, so we both know what that relationship's like, so that was useful. And yeah, we had a lot of fun.
What about working with the boys? Obviously, Michael is quite a funny guy. Did that help on set, particularly during some of the more terrifying scenes?
Yeah, he's a real live wire. I injured him, actually, in the fight scene, which didn't go down too well. But I hope he forgives me. I did keep injuring people.
Can you elaborate on how you injured Michael?
Well, we were doing a huge fight scene, and I had trained with a real fighter, not a stunt coordinator. So I'd kind of learned how to fight for real. So then I had to sort of try and pull it back when we were doing the fight scene, and I just kept forgetting. I kept like doing a real kick instead of a fake kick, and so he got hurt a few times, which, yeah. I think it's just, it's that thing of being completely taken away and complete escapism, and I suppose, yeah, that's just to be taken away on a journey and to be, and go through all those emotions that the film's making you feel, like being scared, all of that, just going on an emotional journey. I think that's always good. I just hope they laugh, really. I hope that they're entertained and they think it's really funny, because, yeah, I do. I think it's a really funny, really entertaining film, so.
Hi, my name's Benjamin Buffer. I'm the director of Double Date.
Ben, it's fantastic to have you at FrightFest. What does it mean for you to showcase the film at this festival specifically?
Specifically at this festival, I mean, I would say it's probably UK's biggest horror genre festival. I mean, I'd say it pretty much is. I know that the main organisers of this are just, you know, very, very cool guys who I've heard personally talk now about what it means to them to sort of support filmmakers like us. So, I mean, yes, it's, that's obviously to someone like me, who's a first-time film director, that's just a really big deal. And I mean, basically, my movie's now playing in Leicester Square in a 700-seater, you know, kind of, and yeah, and I was walking here with my wife, and she's just kind of like, it's amazing. Like, it's a really sunny day, and you're going to Leicester Square to see your film. So, yeah, I'm super chuffed with FrightFest. They're amazing. The thing that most excited me about this film is that it was written and by one of my best friends, really, a guy who I adore and just love hanging out with. And we've been collaborating now for 5 years, making shorts, and it's just working with someone like that gives, you know, it's my first film, but I was given almost free rein, and essentially working with a lead and an actor and a producer, Matt Wilkinson, who spearheaded this film really to get it done, who just allowed me as a first-time director to have almost full creative freedom, which I don't know whether that's the case for a lot of first-time directors, but it was opposite to what I almost thought would happen. You know, I was just given immense freedom, so it's been a brilliant experience. Danny is the lead in it, and brilliant guy. Michael Socker was kind of almost an accident. He came on a week before we were due to shoot, and I mean, he's just like a whirlwind, that guy. I mean, you know, incredible actor, brilliant improviser, full of energy, full of beans. The lovely Kelly Wenham, who's just wandered past me there, who just was, we, you know, auditioned numerous women for that role, and Kelly was just totally standout. Just, you know, there was no one else for that part, and she put herself through hell, basically learning kickboxing and doing a fitness regime and a diet that just like knocked her for six, but she pulled it out of the bag, and I think is, you know, brilliant in this film. And then Georgia Groom, who's just very, very, very funny, very intelligent and very cool young lady, who I think if you've seen London to Brighton, you know, you would know that she's from a young age, very talented actress. So, very lucky with the cast. It all stems, the whole idea stems from Danny being terrified of women. Me and Danny did talk actually when we were first working with the script and first sort of discussing what, you know, the ideas for it and what we were trying to do. And we both realised that we come from very female-dominated families. Yeah, so for us, it was just, I don't know, there was no question that it was kind of, we were going to try and, make the women, you know, just make the women kick ass, basically, or make them hard, or make them a threat. I mean, yeah, I don't know how other women actually perceive these characters. I hope they perceive them in the way that we wanted to, which is that they were supposed to be the main reason why this film was going to be brilliant fun, and why that... I don't know. I can't speak for other women. For me, I just like, yeah, I like that twist of it. You know, the film is a comedy horror. It plays around with those two styles, those two genres. But you know, me and Danny did say that it was kind of we wanted to be silly and we wanted to muck around and we wanted to play and have a good laugh. But whenever we wanted to go to any horror elements or violence or suspense, you know, I don't necessarily class myself as a comedy director. It's just I'm working with someone who loves comedy. I actually really love, you know, horror and suspense and thriller and action and all these different things. So it was never it was just a conscious choice that it was like, when we do go to the action, it's going to be brutal or to the horror, and it will be harsh or it will be violent or it will be suspenseful. And when we go to the comedy, it's very silly. But to me, it always still felt like one thing. There was never any point where I feel like I'm leaping. It's all remaining in one style. It's just that within that style, all of this is happening. It's kind of hard to explain, but it seems to really work. People seem to comment the fact that there is just a nice blend. It's not, there's not two different things happening at once, you know.